गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन. दिस इज अ वीडियो फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 6, सब्जेक्ट साइंस. एंड टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 5, दैट इज सेपरेशन ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस. It is your lecture number 1. So children, in this lecture, we will do some pre-text activities. Okay? We will do some pre-text activities and we will cover 3 activities in this lecture. By these activities, you will come to know about the various methods of the separation. So let's start with our activity 1. Bring a bucket of grain purchased from a shop to the classroom. Now spread the grain on a sheet of paper. Do you find only one kind of grain on the sheet of paper? Tell me, do you find only one kind of grain? Answer is no. There are many kinds of grain on the sheet of paper and the size of the grains are also different. Okay, so the answer is no. But now the question is, have you ever thought that how can we separate stones from grains? Like if we want to separate the stones from these grains, then which method we should use? Or how can you separate these stones from grains? So children, it is possible to separate stones from grains. And we can separate stones from grains by hands. We can separate stones from grains by hands. It is the most convenient way to separate stones or any other larger impurity from the substance. So children, this method of removing stones, husks and other grains with hands is called hand picking. The hand picking method is a method for separating the substance. Okay, it is a method of separation. Now look at this picture. In this picture, the man is picking the stones with hands and throw it away. And this method is called hand picking method. Like you can also remove the stone from rice and pulses by using this method. Now, we will start our activity number 2. Make a mixture of dry sand with sawdust and powdered dry leaves. Keep this mixture on a plate or a newspaper. Can the two different components be made out easily? Are the sizes of the particles of the two components similar? So the answer is no. The sizes of the particles of the two components are not similar. They are different. there are different sizes of particles. Okay. So would it be possible to separate the components by hand picking? Would it possible? No. It's not possible to separate the components by hand picking. But now the question is, how can we separate this mixture? Which method we should use to separate this mixture? So let us study a procedure to separate this mixture, that which procedure we should follow to separate this mixture. So for separating the mixture, you have to follow these steps. First of all, take your mixture in an open ground and stand on a raised platform. Then put the mixture on a plate or a sheet of paper. And after that, hold the plate at your shoulder height. Okay. Hold the plate at your shoulder height. Do both the components, means sand and sawdust, fall at the same place? No, they do not fall at the same place. They do not fall at the same place. Okay, so if they do not fall at the same place, it means in this way they separate from one another. Okay, and this method of separating components of a mixture with the help of wind or by blowing air is called winnowing. Okay, this method of separation is called winnowing. Now look at this picture. This picture shows winnowing, and she is separating the components of a mixture with the help of wind. Okay, and this method is called winnowing. Winnowing is a method of separation. Now our next activity is activity number 3. Bring a sieve and a small quantity of flour from home. It is easily available in your home, right? Now see the flour to separate any impurities in it. So children, if you use sieve, then can it possible to remove impurities from the flour by sieving? Can we separate the flour from impurities by sieving? So the answer is yes. We can easily separate the flour from impurities by sieving. It is the easiest way to separate the flour by sieving. Like you have seen many times that your mom separate the flour by sieving, right? Sieving allows the fine flour particles to pass through the holes of the sieve. Means the tiny, small flour particles can easily pass through the holes of the sieve, while the bigger particles, means impurities, remain on the sieve. Okay, so in this way, we can separate impurities from the flour particles. This picture shows the sieving process or method of separation by sieving. So students, this is your homework. Question number 1 is, which method you used for separating the pebbles from sand? Means you have to write the appropriate method which is used for separating the pebbles from sand. Question number 2 is, which method is used for separating the stones from rice and pulses? I repeat, question number 2 is, which method is used for separating the stones from rice and pulses? Question number 3 is, which method is used for separating different kinds of vegetables from the mixture of vegetables in the basket? Next question is, which method is used for separating the dust particles from the grain? I repeat, question number 4 is, which method is used for separating the dust particles from the grain? Question number 5 is, which method is used for separating the tea leaves from tea? I repeat, question number 5 is, which method is used for separating the tea leaves from tea? So children, these 5 questions are based on your activities, and you have to write these answers in your FAIR notebook. Okay? This ends for today's lecture. Thank you.